Oh, hey, Uncle. Guess who's hosting Fresh today? It's the Shortland Street staff. You know that guy Frankie Adams and Shavaughn Ruakere?
Oh, yeah. Do I know Shavaughn Ruakere? She's a beauty one, isn't it?
Hard out, Uncle.
Huh? I wish she could be my niece.
Yeah, but you'd have to have a sickness first, Uncle.
I'll be lousy.
My name is Shavaughn Ruakere.
And I'm Frankie Adams.
Welcome to our freshy picnic. Hey, look, I even bought those little umbrellas from the $2 shop.
Hello. Complimenting our coconut water pretty well. You look like a princess today, Shavi.
Kia ora, mate. You look like an evil witch.
In the sunshine. All right, enough of that. Let's take a look at today's menu.
Coming up on Fresh Today, we catch up with Black Grace and Pani and Pani on the search for Mr Lavalava.
This is a race. First team, obviously, you will be the winners. The last team, one of you will be eliminated today.
Woo!
That's what we've got coming up for you today. But first, we're going to get a little bit contemporary on it with the fine brothers and sisters from the Black Race.
Yes, Polly's doing their thing on the worldwide stage. Now, these guys are incredible, right,
Shane? They are absolutely amazing. They put my dance moves to shame.
Oh, show us your dance moves.
I mean, hip-hop, I think it was more of a hobby for me, but with the contemporary and stuff, putting that narrative to dance was sort of appealing to me. I was introduced to ballet, there's things I wasn't used to, and like pointing my toes was a big challenge, so I'm still working on that.
I've been asked to do lots of different projects, and I generally don't. I sort of stick with the, you know, this is what I do. But recently I decided that I would make myself as uncomfortable as possible. So with this particular work, I'm going to use some Tupac and Dr. Dre because I haven't before and I really like it.
Definitely challenging, a lot of hard work, a lot of sweat and tears, but there's big rewards for it as well, performing in front of the audiences that Black Grace gets. Usually in the hip-hop realms it's sort of like rowdy and loud and stuff, but dancing here, people actually take it in, try to figure out the stories that we're trying to tell.
It's a huge privilege to be able to be a practicing artist in this country, to make a career out of it, and to have your work shown internationally, and I'm really proud of that.
You know, they've been around for like almost going on to their 20th year, and to be a part of it is quite an honour and a privilege.
Frankie, when I'm at home by myself dancing in the living room, I look just like them.
Yeah, you do. Like, you twerk and you just, you know, you shake it.
I'm going to be honest with you. At my age, you don't twerk. If you twerk, it hurts.
But hey, if you were to take over the world with your twerking, who would you take advice from if it was anyone in the entire world? Fortune teller.
Oh, fortune teller. I love fortune teller. Oh, this is good. All right. And I know who she's telling the fortune of today. He's a fella who is a Hollywood star, and he also starred with us on Shorty Street until they killed him off. But you know, all the good ones die.
Is my husband cheating on me?
Will I marry my future wife in the next 2 years?
Will I win the lotto this weekend?
Hi, I'm fortune teller.
Don't think that's a good idea.
Got it, Chief.
Wow, Marlo and Late John, I'm so happy to see you.
Hey,
well, I always want to say this one of my favorite movies when I saw you on Battleground. Yeah, oh wow, can't believe it, you're here in the fridge.
I can't believe I'm here either.
Is there something that's bothering you, something that's on your mind that you maybe want to know a bit more about?
Yeah, you know, I was wondering if I'm ever gonna get an Oscar nomination. No, seriously.
Okay, Oscar nomination? Well, no, we can ask the spirits. I can, whatever, my opinion doesn't count. It's all up to the spirits. And so you're wondering if you're going to be working with Oscar? Oscar Gottlieb, is that the one?
No. You know the big gold silver man, the award?
Have you gone to that Asian shop in Queen Street? It's only $5 for one of those. But you want to be nominated now, right? Okay.
I'm just hoping if it would happen in the next 30 minutes.
Oh, never. Okay, let's ask the spirits and see what we... This is the spirit of Oscars, okay? Oscars. Okay. These cards tell the truth, John. Just like a truth thing. How are you feeling at the moment?
Hot.
You look hot.
It's because I'm a teller.
Oh, yeah, all right. Okay. First of all, let's see what the spirit of Oscars Hollywood say. This is your first... Oh, this.
What's this?
This, right? This means your lovers.
A lover with the Oscars?
No, lovers with me. So yes. In order for you to get an Oscar, me and you have to be together.
I do my best.
You believe it?
Yes, ma'am.
Please believe it. Now the second one. Oh.
Knight and swords.
It's a knight and swords.
Knight and swords.
Yeah. Do you know what this means? That means you are my knight in shiny armor. And you're riding a horse because it's your favorite.
It's my favorite.
Yeah, but on the barbecue or...
Good protein.
But you are coming to pick me up?
Yeah.
In the horse.
With a chariot?
Yeah, you need a chariot to carry me. The horse can't carry me. It's the last card?
Yeah.
You know what this card means?
Star on the side.
That means you're going to be on the... You know where they have the stars on the Hollywood?
Yeah.
The walk, what's it called again?
The Hollywood walk?
Yeah, you're going to be walking right past me. Yeah, so I
knew I'd get close.
I think that basically you answer if you're going to get Oscar. No, I can't see it.
I'll take it, Tala.
But you're still happy with that?
I'm very happy.
I'm happy with this.
Very, very happy.
Such a wise woman, that fortune teller.
The wisest of them all. Can we please have a clap for Maya, our bubble wrangler? She's our bubble girl. We're going to take a break now, but you need to stick around because when we come back, I'm going to take you into my world.
The best world there is.
Us Kiwis, we tend to be so shy and we're like, no, shame, I don't want to do that. And, no, man, I'm so happy I did that because that was the start of my entire career in TV, which I'm proud of myself.
Freshies, now you've all seen my world, but now's the time to see my favourite Maldives world. Introducing...
Kia ora! Welcome, Aramai, to my world.
I said hurry up, man!
Everybody just plan.
So I grew up in Taranaki, I'm a Naki girl heart, and I'm the youngest of four kids. My dad, this is cool, because if you know Shortland Street, this is cool. My dad is a doctor in real life, and my mum's a nurse. And I played a nurse on Shorty, married to a doctor. Ooh, trippy A.
I know what it's like to not be with the one you love.
I lived in New Plymouth, in the Naki, until I left school. And then I did 1 year at university. I moved to the big smoke, Auckland. I feel like my break in TV was a real right place, right time kind of thing. I was seeing this fella in my hostel at university, and we've been going out a couple of months, and then he dumped me, and I was like, oh, so heartbroken. I was like curled up in a ball in my room, just bawling my eyes out for like a week, you know. It was like my first real heartbreak. And my sister was like, I want to cheer you up, I'm going to take you shopping. So she took me downtown, and that's where I met this girl who was working in a shop who gave me a card for a talent agency. Anyway, turns out the boyfriend, this is the best part of the story, is actually gay, and that's why he dumped me. We're mates now, but... So I really have the gay ex-boyfriend to thank for my entire career.
This is my world, this is our brand new set of what now? This is the Breakfast Crew, you're saying what?
Okay, so I was 18 years old. I had to move from Auckland to Christchurch, where they filmed What Now? I didn't know a soul down there in the South Island. And suddenly, I was doing live TV 5 days a week. Put on a wig, we put on some makeup, and we'd just make up a character and an accent. So it was just so much fun, and I learnt so much there as well. I was a dungy man. I think for years I thought because I was a presenter, I knew how to be an actor, but nah. Cliff Curtis gave me this piece of advice. You know Cliff Curtis, eh? He said, if you want to be an actor, you have to go and train. So I left presenting. I said, I'm going to be an actor. This is what I'm going to do. So the next year and a half was horrible. I was like, bored of red line, just going to auditions. Oh, you know, the self-esteem goes whoosh. Like that, eh? It was a tough time, and if my mum and dad weren't there to help, you know, pay the bills, as they did, which was real cool of them, I don't know what would have happened. But after a year and a half of slogging it out, got the call from Shorty Street.
What are you doing?
IV blood.
I asked for morphine.
Right.
What's with you today?
What do you mean?
You're heading somewhere else. Wake up. Move it.
Hey, go.
Tenting and acting. Well, yeah, it's just that thing of suddenly I'm having to read someone else's words as opposed to my own, and I have to do things that I don't like sometimes. Like my character did some stuff that was like, you know, she had an affair on TK Man with the white boy, you know what I'm talking about. You know, so you're like, oh no, I don't want to do that.
Every day I walk into ED and there's every mistake I ever made just staring me right in the face.
I'm really thankful for having been on Shorty, but I just wanted to know what else was out there in the acting world because it is so fast. Having spent time in LA, it's such a rad city, but it's hard, and I know how difficult it'd be over there, and you know, kind of, it does crush a lot of people trying to be an actor over there. I want to go over there and work if the work comes up, but actually this is my home. If it all worked out for me, you know, dream of dreams, I would get the work overseas and go when I needed to, but this is home for me. I think in the end, being brave enough to pick up that little card I have with that little phone number on it for this talent agency and to ring them up and go see them, it was the best thing I could have ever done. And I can't believe, like, and us Kiwis, we tend to be so shy, and we're like, no, shame, I don't want to do that, and oh, people might think I'm being a show-off or something. Nah, man, I could not have done it, you know. I'm so happy I did that, actually. I'm proud of myself. Yeah, because that was the start of my entire career in TV, and if I hadn't called them up, I don't know what would have happened, man. I'd probably be living in a park somewhere.
Wow, Shav, you are so interesting.
Oh, shut up, Egg! My world was like awesome and stuff.
So interesting. I'm like, whoa.
You know, I'll tell you what, who's got a better world than the two of us?
Hey.
Pani and Pani, right?
Oh, living it up in Samoa, sorry about it.
More of Pani and Pani after the break.
Back freshies to this glorious day.
All right, let's move on very swiftly to Pani and Pani and the quest they have set for themselves to find Mr. Lavalava.
We have been searching all around the Pacific to see the best guy each island has to offer.
And from the thousands of auditions that we've had here in Samoa, we have selected 10 warriors who will be put to the test.
Previously on The Search for Mr. Lavalava.
As long as you have a lay, you will remain in the competition.
Now, if you lose a challenge, you lose a lay. And if you no longer have one, you will be eliminated.
Mel!
I kind of discovered this is not working.
And the person going home is Marcus.
Gosh, I need some water.
You all look so
handsome.
Handsome today.
Yes. Do you need a drink of water or anything, boys? No? You don't need a drink? You're all good? Well, the thing is, we need a drink.
That's right.
Very, very thirsty. And there is a particular type of water that we're after, our sister, and that is the juice, the nectar of the gods found in the coconut.
You will be in teams of three. One of you will be climbing up the coconut tree. One of you will be husking the coconut. One of you will be breaking open the coconut with amba'a, AKA stone. And then all three of you together will be running to bring us the nectar of the gods, the coconut juice. This is a race. First team, obviously, you will be the winners. The last team, one of you will be eliminated today. Are you ready?
Yes!
Well, when I heard it was a team challenge, I was so relieved that I could decide, actually, I'm not going to be the one that's going to climb the tree. I'm scared of heights. I can climb, but when I get up there, I can't come down.
I think about the challenge, it's going to be really hard because it involves a lot of physical work. I don't know who might win.
On your marks. Get steady. Get pretty.
Go!
Oh my gosh, look at them. They're climbing up that tree. Oh, how I wish I was a trunk.
Bengus climbing was pretty good. He was really fast too.
When we got up the tree, we were definitely coming first.
We're the last ones there and the last ones up.
We were just focusing on getting our news down.
They're climbing, they're going for that nut.
We are the first one who grabbed the coconut and get a mele'i.
We got down first, but I think the other guys got there before us. They actually crossed us over and, you know, kind of like took us off on our game plan, but we had to get back on it.
It was sort of nerve-wracking because I saw everyone else getting their coconuts down and, you know, they were all gapping it and we were still waiting for Andrew.
And they're running to husk and pull it all out and scream and shout.
So yeah, when we got to the husking station, we were just trying to get the mele'i in the ground and holding it, you know, for Calvin to husk the coconut.
And they are husking, and now they've got the nut, and they need to crack their nuts.
Team number one.
Yeah, as soon as we started running, you know, right over that big swimming pool over there, yeah, we were actually quite confident. We were just happy that we didn't come last.
Fantastic. Team number two.
We're supposed to win because we did it fast, but at the end, we are the last one.
Thank you very much. Team number three.
Coming first felt really good until I saw Vito's presentation.
See, Vito had a secret he didn't want to share with everybody else.
I already told to my boys, to my team, but I didn't tell it to the other boys because we need a win.
Where we have to announce a winner, yay! And unfortunately, someone has to go home. So we'd like to call upon the group that came last. Please step forward. Sam, Vito, Itzia. Tia, as you know, you are lucky because you have immunity, you have two lays, so you will be safe. But for you two, there's a bit of a twist. It wasn't just about coming first, it was about completing the job. So we would like to also announce that your team came first. And the reason why this group came first, they presented the coconuts to Pani as a male should to a female.
Man, that's what my dad told me. He said, son, if you're gonna go grab a coconut for a girl, then you had to suit it. Don't crack it in. But if it's for a chief or for a man, then you had to crack it, because the man always drink with the crack one. But the ladies, they drink with the suit in you.
And we'd like to announce the winner of this team, a young gentleman by the name of Vito. Can you please step forward? Hello. Hello. Oh boy. Here we go, guys. It just came down to husking. You had one job each, but one of you did two jobs to help someone who wasn't able to fully do it on their own. The losing team is this group here. Can you please step forward? But someone has to go home, and for that reason, the husking issue, we have to send Calvin home today. So sorry.
The losing part was unexpected, but I kind of felt it coming. It's a competition, and we all have to work hard and do our best for it. Whoever stays, they deserve to continue on with the competition.
Okay, guys, are you ready for the next challenge?
Yeah!
I feel better. Amazing. And appropriate. Again. Amazing.
Next week, on the search for Mr. Lavalava. You have going to try and rule our beautiful Bisamoa.
Hello. Ooh.
I will save all the money I can, and I will take you to Africa. You like McDendo? I mean Mandela.
Hanging out with you today on Fresh.
Yes, we have, but it's time to say goodbye. Have you got any final words?
I'm just going
to
say something.
Kia ora! It was awesome seeing you and lovely hanging out with you. Ka kite ono.
We're here at Home Ground today. Bittersweet. This is our last performance in New Zealand as Leisure Mystic. Wait, check out our peoples!
Myself, don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my shining sun, my guiding light, my love.
This is my skip the wine in the candlelight, broke it down at night.
Chill.
Tell me, huh?